We're ready. Okay, it's 4 o'clock and we're going to call the planning board meeting of the city of Panama City to order, the meeting of July the 10th. And if we would, please take.
James Barker.
Here.
Doug Crosby.
Here.
Christopher Stamps. Brian Neubauer.
Here.
Ray Dubuque.
Here. Are there any changes or deletions to the agenda? Okay, seeing none, proceed with the approval of the minutes of the June 12th, 2023 meeting. I have a motion.
I'll move we approve.
Have a motion and a second to approve. There is no further discussion. Please take the roll.
James Barker.
Yes.
Doug Crosby.
Yes.
Brian Neubauer.
Yes.
Ray Dubuque.
Yes. Are there any announcements or disclosures that need to be made before we start? Let me just mention to the audience, if you haven't been to one of these before, kind of the way it runs is that the staff will present the item. At that point, board members will have a chance to ask any questions of staff they may have. Then we'll ask the applicant if they would like to provide any additional information on the application or answer any questions that may have. I talked about silence and phones, and guess who didn't do it? Okay, now mine's muted. Please mute your phones if you haven't. At that point, we will have audience participation. And everyone will get a chance to participate. If you have a question or a comment you'd like to make on an item, you will get a chance. So we ask that you just be civil, and everything is recorded. So make sure when you come to the mic, state your name and address so that it'll go on the record and it's recorded and the minutes are provided to the city commission. All of the items today will be acted on by the city commission. Variances are the only thing this board has the semi-final decision on. We make recommendations to city commission. The items will be heard the first reading. There's two readings of each item when it goes to the city. The first reading for these items is on Tuesday, August the 8th at 8 a.m. They meet at the county complex at 840 West 11th Street in the county commission chambers is where they meet. There's two readings, as I said. The second reading, which sometimes is the final, sometimes depending on what happens, there's another one, is Tuesday, August the 22nd, 2023. They typically don't take actions on the first reading. It's just strictly a reading. However, I have seen them recently on one that they did. So, if you want to make a comment, city commission, I encourage you to go to the city commission meetings or contact your city commissioner prior to. All right. And I understand that Mr. Burke would like to make an announcement.
Yeah. Excuse me, Mr. Chairman. All these matters today are quasi-judicial in nature. It means that we'll take sworn testimony. So if you plan to speak today on a matter, if you'll please stand now and raise your right hand and repeat after me. We only got one taker.
Patient season.
Yeah. Do you solemnly swear or affirm that the testimony you'll give in these matters to be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth? Perfect. When you come to the microphone and speak on a matter, if you'll please state that you have been sworn.
I think it was one gentleman in the back of the striped shirt.
Question?
Yes.
If you want to just ask a question, do you have to be sworn
in? You're going to speak, and I'd like for you to be sworn in. Good. Anybody that's going to speak today, please stand and raise your right hand.
Yeah. Better safe than sorry.
Yeah. Yes, you don't have to speak, and it doesn't matter. Do you solemnly swear or affirm to the testimony you'll give today to be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth? Thank you.
Now, just to clarify, if you're an applicant and you're here, I hope you stood. We swore you in. All right, very good. Moving on, item A.
Request 5A is case number CPMA 2354. It's a request for an annexation, land use change, and rezoning of approximately 0.34 acres from residential 1 R1 in Bay County to residential 1 R1 in Panama City. The property is located at 143 Queen Circle. Blake and Ashley Watts Reese are the owners, and Blake Reese is the applicant.
Request for annexation. Is it for connection of water and sewer? No. Okay. Yeah, follow. It's all right. Any questions from the board for staff? Seeing none, the applicant, you said it is for water and sewer connection only. Okay, thank you. Anyone else in the audience to address this item? This is the one on Queen Circle. Yes, sir. Please come to the mic. State your name and address for the record.
Tim Wheeler, 106 Queen Circle, and sworn in. My question is it just for this property or is it for the neighborhood?
Just for this property. We are not into forced annexations or...
We don't want it.
You have to apply if you want to be annexed in the city of Panama City.
That's my question.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Anyone else to comment on 143 Queen Circle? Sir.
Good afternoon. Mike Koch, 102 Queen Circle. Obviously, property owners have the right to, they have the utilities available to take advantage of that, those utilities if they seem necessary. It's mostly the issue I'd like to bring up is the notice that the advertisement that was sent out, looking at the Bay County comprehensive plan, the verbiage does not exactly match the Bay County R1 to what's written here. It creates a lot of confusion among residents that are not familiar with that. So that's my request. It's misleading. It kind of puts showing the county has, you can put a quadplex on that property in county, which is not true. And then as a citizen reads it, they say, oh, wait a minute, they're rezoning it to single family, which is what it should be. So that's my statement. That's my question. And I'll leave.
Order. Thank you. We haven't heard that before. So that I'm sure we'll look into that.
I can speak to
you
it.
Can speak to it.
So annexations and future land use changes, we actually utilize the land use categories in the notice, not the zoning districts. The land use categories are more, they're broader, and they include all possible uses of the various zoning districts within the future land use category. This is an approach that we take for even those land use changes within the city. So we also utilize the same verbiage so it's not necessarily that we took it from the zoning district from the county, we took it from their comp plan. So that's if that provides some insight. So yeah, we use the land use verbiage.
But he is correct
that yeah,
the R1 zoning in the county does not allow for that's the future land use designation.
Yeah.
I'd ask the staff if you would look in to see if there's any way maybe to clarify the letter a little bit.
Sure. And we'll go back and make sure that there wasn't any confusion when we sent those out.
Yes.
It just doesn't create a clear picture on the intent of what is currently approved authorized use and what is going to be projected in this case and in your next annexation request in your next within Kingsbury.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you for bringing that up. We had not heard that. Just kind of look into it a little bit. All right. We have anyone else to speak on Queen Circle? Seeing none, do I have a motion?
Second.
Motion to approve. A second. With no further discussion, please take the roll.
James Barker?
Yes.
Doug Crosby?
Yes.
Brian Neubauer? Ray Dubuque?
Yes. Okay. Item B. Savannah, you're looking.
Doing all right.
Then Orlando gets it.
5B is case number CPMA 2355. It is a request for an annexation, land use change, and rezoning of approximately 8.16 acres from residential 1 R1 in Bay County to residential 1 R1 in Panama City. The property is located at 3106 West 27th Street. Daniel W. Davis II is the owner and applicant.
Any questions for the staff? Is the applicant here?
Yes.
The representative, you know the drill?
I'm not Danny. I'm Jim Sloney in a Panhandle Engineering representing Danny Davis. We got about 8 acres on the water. Danny's purchased it. He's going to build a house for his family on the end. And we're going to create a single family detached residential subdivision consistent with the city R1 zoning. It's going to be upscale. The portion that's on the waterfront will have a small access drive, a little more accessible than the two public roadways on the north and south. We're here because in order to acquire the legislatively funded water and sewer program, it's our understanding that we have to annex. So we are annexing similar to these folks right here. So that's what we're here for. Some of the benefits, we don't pay the 1.25 times impact fee that the people in the county will if they connect to the city, or the monthly 1.25 uplift, statutory uplift to the bills. That's our justification. Our stormwater will be treated to water management district standards and discharged into the bay. I'll be glad to answer any questions from you or anybody else.
How many units is he proposing at this time?
I've been in my,
I understand it.
I've been in meeting most of, I don't know, 50. How many do we have?
You can do 80. They can.
Go ahead.
You can do 80.
I'm sorry, I told you I'd mess up. You've seen the CSP. What is it? I don't even know. I just contracted with him.
So the gross, so we're looking at the acreage, gross acreage, about, it's 8 acres. And the maximum gross density is 5. So we're looking up to 40, and that's gross. And it's up to, remember, they're going to have to put in a roadway. They're going to have to make room for right-of-ways. So that's going to eat some of that up. So the likelihood of them maximizing that build out is unlikely, but that's the gross.
Yeah, not 500.
So you have not seen.
We have not done a layout. A preliminary layout has been done by the client. I don't know if it's been shared with staff, but it's not obligatory to be included within a land use change. But yeah, we're going to stay underneath it. We're going to be, I mentioned it was upscale. We have water and sewer coming, which none of the other houses out there have. They have septic tanks and wells, or septic tanks anyway. So the answer is no. It's going to be a nice subdivision in the order of the 40 that Joanne says.
Okay, Will there be internal roads? You mentioned roads.
I just mentioned that there'll be a private roadway along for waterfront lots. The other lots are facing public. Well, I say public roadway. Actually, part of it's public and part of it's privately owned. But the answer is yes, they're existing roads.
Okay. Other questions for the applicant? We're on board questions right now. I know I've seen some of the neighborhood posts about the concern of forced annexation that.
That's a separate issue that Mike will probably talk to. Thank you, Mike. No, the answer is that's why we are doing it. Okay. Not so much forced, enticed by the ability to get water and sewer.
We're not forcing this applicant.
No, there's a public hearing or a public meeting, community meeting tomorrow regarding that project. In case people would like to go to it and understand more.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
I got a question for staff. How does the density between the city and the county vary from R1?
R1, I'm not familiar with the R1 for Bay County. We can look it up.
15 an acre.
It is 15 an acre.
And we're substantially less than that.
Okay. So in the city, we're 5. Acre.
We are 5.
Yeah.
Why did I see something that showed?
And what is 80 actually? How many allows? County allows.
The county allows a higher density than the city.
Okay. All right. I know there's at least one applicant, one person that would like to speak. Ma'am, if you still would like to speak. Your name and address and whether you were sworn in, please.
My name is Kathy Shorts. I live at 2815 Kings Road, which is right across from, I didn't get the official letter, but I did see it on our neighborhood Facebook, and I was sworn in. So just impact questions for the neighborhood and our lives there. I mean, first of all, we had red fox living there, y'all. We had snapping turtles living there, y'all. We had a lot of animals that lived on that property. I know that's not your deal, but that's part of my deal. I do live on Kings Road, so I'll be coming out to that intersection, as all of us do, to leave our neighborhood every morning going to work and the multiple times a day. So my concerns are traffic. Is there going to be a traffic light? 40 homes, we're talking 2 to 3 cars each. A lot of cars, a lot of traffic. Just the general impact on how it's going to affect Kings Point. I ride my bike. I walk my dogs. Most of our neighborhood does. I just don't want to see more traffic. I've lived there, you know, 8 years. A lot of people have lived there a lot longer than that. I'm a Birmingham native. I came here for this small town. So I guess those are the questions that I had. So the density, did you say 5 per acre? Staff, 5 per acre. Okay. I'm a social worker, y'all. That's 2/10 of an acre, or how much of an acre? About 1/10 of an acre per person? Small.
Less roads, right-of-ways, and stuff.
Okay. So will these be the ones that look like you've got a house and you've got a little detached garage with a little driveway through, kind of like sweet back?
We're really not at that.
We don't know that much.
That would be a development or anything.
Okay. Those are the kind of impacts my brain is wanting to know.
Yeah. I understand.
Yeah. What is going on? I have a privacy fence. If this is going to be tall, the people there can see into my privacy fence possibly. So those kinds of things are just the things that I know my neighbors and my family that live in Kings Point are concerned about. And I do have other relatives that live in other houses on Canal Drive. So.
Yeah, you're at the corner of Kings Road and Canal Drive.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
No one from here is going to be able to see.
Yeah, not that far away. Yeah.
When the owner gets ready to subdivide the property, they would bring a preliminary plat to the planning board for their consideration at that time. And it's that stage that we take a look at traffic and stormwater and all that stuff.
So, all right, those are the things. Maybe I'll hit them.
This is strictly annexation and the zoning. Each one of you get a chance. Go ahead and stand up and state your name and address. And were you sworn in when they swore people in?
My name is Mae Bennett, and I live on Island View Circle. And if that's that, if he's trying to put that thing that doesn't have any houses in it in the city, it's going to affect me. How many houses he puts on, because we're in the little circle and we don't have many houses down there and we don't have much traffic. Now, when I built my house in 70, it was the third house on the block and my kids could run and play and swim in the bayou. Then people started coming, and the lady next door had a dog, and she took the dog stuff and threw it in the bayou, and my kids couldn't swim anymore. So when we were out there, there were 3 houses. My kids, where it's now Kings Point, practiced shooting guns, because there was nothing out there. All right. So I have been out there, and I told my kids on Sunday, you can't drive your bicycles because people are driving through looking. So I know about the traffic that has come with houses.
Yes, ma'am.
And I don't want to be in the city. I bought my house so I could be way out. And now people have built around me.
Yes, ma'am. We understand.
Thank you.
Now, is Island View Circle the one at the end of 27th
yeah,
Street?
Yeah, it's at the end of 27th Street. It says no thing. And it is a little circle, and there's Durwood's old home, and then a new home was built, and us, there was Durwood, us, and the house next door, Dimples Duncan owned it, and that were the three houses that were out there.
This request will not impact as far as zoning or whether you're in the city or county for your property. You will stay in the county, your property.
Yeah, because if it does, I mean, if his 8 acres that he wants to put more houses on, you know, we all have, you know, nice yards. So, and when we built our house, we built it, you had to have it from 50 from the street. And when Opal came, it came up to the bottom step of my garage. And that's it. Well, it came in the next door neighbors because their house is back. But I have, and Michael only took out 23 trees, and that's all we had. Damage.
This should not impact your property at all.
Well, honey, we built our house with things on it, hurricane straps on it. So
anything they build will have to be built to the new code too.
When we built our house, we built it to stay in.
And I think one of the keys is there'll be less density in the city than the county would allow.
So you could do more density right now.
So thank you, ma'am. You want to speak, sir? Yes, if you weren't sworn in, the city attorney will have to swear you.
Solemnly swear affirm the testimony you're about to give to be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth.
I do.
Thank you. Name and address, please.
My name is Dr. Robert Kopp. Yeah, I live in the house she referred to as the Dimples Duncan house.
What is that address?
That's 2939. Island View Circle.
Okay, thank you, sir.
So, I'm sorry, but I didn't understand exactly what we're supposed to be doing here, and what we're not. So I don't want to waste your time by.
The applicant has requested to annex into the city as a residential one zoning from the county. And that has to come before us for a recommendation to city, and then the city acts one way or the other.
But as I understand from listening to the other people, that's not obligatory for us.
No, sir.
Not that could happen to them and bypass us.
Yes, sir.
So it's almost like an island in the storm.
Most people we have seen annexed from this area are because their septic tanks are failing and they need to connect to city services. Uh-huh. But there's no forced annexation going on in Panama City.
Okay. So about the houses, the prospective houses, is there any input that we can
They apply for the development order, it'll have more of a layout. It still won't have the design of the houses. My assumption is they're going to be builders buy them or owners buy them and build whatever kind of house they want.
May I ask this gentleman a question?
You can ask the board a question.
Okay.
And then recognize.
I'm just, the only thing I can think of is if you're familiar with the Sweetwater.
Oh, yes.
You are, okay. So they had a lot of really pretty houses there when they first opened. Now they're making, I don't know what you call it, high density living there. We used to call it projects. That's what they look like, and that's what they are as far as I'm concerned. Is it going to be like that?
That we don't know. Sweetwater's a little different. They've got a planned unit development. They've got different regulations and setbacks. The way we have now in the city, staff, will you?
I'd like to respond to him if I can.
Okay. Please restate your name and address. If you move over, sir, we need to have him speak to the mic.
Yes, Dr. Cotton. No, what's being proposed
is. I want you to restate your name.
Oh, now that's a question. Jim Slonina. All we're proposing is single-family detached residential houses with actually side setbacks better than what our friend said on Sweet they have. No high density, no verticalness, simple houses. Danny and his family want to live on the point. They bought the property and they'd like to develop it now with the Sebring and water sewer in.
Thank you. Hey. That takes a big load off. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Anyone else? Okay, any other questions for the applicant from the board? Seeing none, do I have a motion?
I move to approve.
Second. Have a motion to approve?
Second.
All right, if there's no further discussion, please take the roll.
James Parker?
Yes.
Doug Crosby?
Yes.
Brian Newbauer?
Yes.
Ray Dubuque?
Yes.
All right, moving on to all you that were here for that item. Are you going to stay or are you going to? You can stay if you'd like. I just want to be able to hear it if we move on. Appreciate y'all coming. By the way, I live down that road, so I drive by every day. Okay, moving on to item C.
Item C is case number CPMA 2356. It's a request for an annexation, land use change, and rezoning of approximately 0.55 acres from residential 1 R1 Bay County to general commercial 2 EC2 Panama City at 3128 West 23rd Court. Stony Point Investments LLC is the owner and Michael K. Weber is the applicant.
Okay. Is the applicant here? Not seeing the applicant. Did that person give you any idea what he's planning to do with commercial in that area?
He also owns the property to the south, so they're trying to annex it in and have it zoned the same as the other property.
He's an engineer. His office is to the south.
Okay.
With Weber's offices?
Yeah.
Okay. It's on.
Okay.
It's on
23rd Street.
Is there anyone in the audience that wants to speak to this one? Surprised, many of you in your residential going to commercial generate some interest.
Back here, but you can't see around the
bus behind them. Oh, I couldn't see you back there. Please state your name and address for the record.
Solemnly swear affirm the testimony you're about to give to be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth.
Yes. Angela Davis, my address is 2337 Bayview Avenue. I know that I am not in close proximity of this. It's like around the corner from me. But I am curious, though, what they're planning on doing since it's going to be turned into commercial.
We didn't get any indication. Just I know. That he wanted to combine it with the lot that he owns.
Yeah, I don't know that we have any specific details, except that he has his professional office that fronts 23rd Street. He's an engineer, professional engineer. And I think ultimately his desire is to expand his business.
So is his office the insurance agency or the one?
MK Weber.
That's the MK Weber Engineer.
Engineer.
There was just other properties, you know, up along that street. So I would just, you know, like, well, I don't know, you know. And that house was residential forever and set there empty. So I just didn't know, you know, what anybody was going to do with it. So I was just, thank you. Okay.
Thank you.
Any other comments, questions? Seeing none, do I have a motion?
We approve. Second.
Okay, we have a motion and a second. No further discussion. Please take the roll.
James Barker?
Yes.
Doug Crosby?
Yes.
Ryan Neubauer?
Yes.
Ray Dubuque?
With reservations, yes. I just wish the applicants would understand the importance of coming to the meeting to answer questions we have. I know that's come up a number of times. We talked about some sort of an action to take when they don't, but maybe we'll work on that. Item D.
Item D is case number CPMA.
Got another question for you real quick, it looks like.
Oh. Yeah, we've already voted, so go ahead.
No, it's it's regardless. So I know that whenever that happens, does it make just that partial commercial? It does not affect any of the other
that's
parcels
correct.
On the
that's
street.
Correct. It's just that one part.
Okay. That's what I wanted to
know. Okay. Orlando.
Item D is case number CPMA 2357. The request is for a land use change and rezoning of approximately 0.18 acres from general commercial 2, GC2, Panama City, to mixed use 2 and U2, Panama City at 1200 Martin Luther King Jr. Boulevard. Farrell Lee Moore is the owner and now.
Okay. And for my own clarification, this is next to a property we just rezoned not long ago, but a couple of months ago.
Yeah. I'm the applicant, though.
Okay. All right. Anyone have any questions for the board? Any questions for the applicant? Sometimes if there's no questions, that's a good thing. You don't have to, but you can if you'd like. Sure, stand up, state your name and address.
Name is Farrell Lee Moore. Address is 118 Lake Merrill Trail, Southport. And I'm the owner of the property on 1200 North Cove. And the reason why I'm applying for this rezoning, because I used to live there before they expanded the highway. And so now I just want to have the same opportunity as my neighbor did to rebuild back there. So that's my main purpose. And the square footage of the house, this is going to be a single dwelling home, part of somewhere between 2100 to 2300 square feet. I think that's what it allows me to build on that particular lot.
I want to thank you for coming to the meeting. And that's honest, I do.
I have a suggestion, though. If those don't show up, push them to the next meeting until they do show up.
That's Oscar Mott. Thank you, sir. Any other questions or comments? If not, do I have a motion?
Motion to approve.
Mark, are you second?
Yes, I do.
Get you closer to the mic. Okay. We have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? If not, please take the roll.
James Barker?
Yes.
Doug Crosby?
Yes.
Ryan Neubauer?
Yes.
Ray Dubuque?
Yes. And let's see. We do have a section in here for audience participation. If there's anyone left that would like to say anything. We are open to that. Seeing none, I just make an announcement that Ms. Parker did an excellent job with the invocation at the city meeting a couple weeks ago. And it was short and sweet, and that's the way they need to be. Yes.
I did want to make a quick announcement. Savannah Brown, planner two, she recently passed her AICP exam. So she is now a candidate to be a certified planner. So we're just very excited, and we thought the planning board would like to know. Yeah, so we just wanted to put that out there. So it was officially announced within the last couple of weeks or so on the in the APA newsletter and everything. So we're just excited, and we wanted to share that.
That's great.
Yes. Exactly. That's the point.
Oh, but that's great.